Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, world over, all our brothers and sisters, wherever you are. Hope you're taking care of your health and your wellness. When we talk about your wellness, that means you've got to be mentally strong and you've got to be physically strong. When you're mentally strong, your body will physically follow and you will not have any difficulty, any problem, any ailment. Ladies and gentlemen, Saturday morning in India and world over, it's a new morning, it's a new beginning, it's a new era, it's a new setup and a startup, because today we are going to do something very pious related to empowering the entire education system globally. Our series, which we started on 5th of June, Making Education Relevant, Global Confluence of Educators and Motivators. Today in that series, we are starting a new program, new process, and that is what Lord Buddha's teaching, preaching, views, sermons, whatever he conveyed to all of us, to the entire humanity, what's its relevance in today's education, particularly our teachers, our educators, and our youth. Those are part of the ecosystem, and also parents, you play a very important role in formulating your child future career growth and of course the mental makeup. So ladies and gentlemen, this morning we are privileged, we are honored, we have got a very distinguished and very esteemed guest with us this morning, Venerable Dr. Dhammapiya ji. He is a Secretary General, International Buddhist Confederation. We extend a very, very hearty welcome to Venerable Dr. Dhammapiya ji. Aapka bahut bahut swagat hai. Aapka bahut bahut welcome hai. I'm so grateful to you that you have been very kind to spare your most valuable time to be with us this morning. Ladies and gentlemen, before I take you to the cerebrum, to the wisdom, to the knowledge of Dr. Dhammapiya ji, I would like to share with you, who are we? Why are we doing this program? What is the necessity and what is the need of this program? How it is relevant today? And why world over people should join in this particular campaign? We would like to share with each one of you. First of all, our deep gratitudes and thanks to each one of you for joining us this morning. Wherever you are world over, we bow our head before you. Thank you very much for joining. And when we talk about Buddham Sharanam Gacchami, let me share few slides with you quickly before I start my conversation with the Venerable Dr. Dhammapiya ji. Ladies and gentlemen, today the entire world is passing through a difficult phase, difficult times. It's a COVID-19, it's a pandemic. People are locked down, children are at home. And as the statistics of the UNESCO and United Nations shows that almost about 850 million children and the youth, roughly half the world's population of the students, they are at present away from schools, colleges and universities, and they are at their respective homes. We can understand how difficult it is for parents to take care of them, how difficult it is for parents to understand their mental makeup, and to keep them happy, and to keep them agile, and to keep them healthy, and at the same time, thinking about their well-being, how the children should maintain a balance of their body and mind, and they should take care of their wellness. We pray to Almighty, all of us together, through the Buddhist philosophy this morning, that we send our best wishes, and from Lord Buddha's preaching, and from Dhammapiya ji, we send our best wishes. Please take care of your health. Ladies and gentlemen, there is a Western school of thought and there's a philosophy. What is the purpose of education? Why education? Why do we go to school? Why do we go to college? Why do we go to polytechnic? Why do I pick up a particular skill? Why do I want a particular degree or a diploma or a certificate? Why do I need that piece of paper? When I look at that entire thing and when I study, whatsoever in a humble way, I'm trying to educate myself the best possible way And whatever knowledge we are acquiring, my chamber, whatsoever we do the research on day-to-day basis, we try to share with all of you. The purpose of education as per the Western school of thought is the preference is given to economics. That means if you're studying, if you're taking education, you should be in a position to earn. You should get some money. You should either start your own business or you work for someone. Parents and children both have got the psyche and the philosophy that education has to be directly related to business, and that thought process has prevailed in the present times, which has come after industrial era. We will have an analysis of that, whether that is good or bad, whatever it is. But economics is given the first preference. And when I read a book called Rich Dad, Poor Dad, a lot of things comes to me. What is being taught? Why it is being taught? What do we want to achieve? The second part is social norms. Third is culture. And the fourth is personal. Personal from youth point of view. Why do they take art, science, commerce, non-medical, medical? Whether they are in school, they are in college, they are in institution, they are in university, they are going for higher education, they are going for technical education, engineering, medical, or they are going for management. Why are they going for a particular? That is called personal. So these four areas, when we talk about, remember, I have given the first preference to economics in the Western school of thought as far as purpose of education is concerned. Now, let me take you to Indian era and let me bring you to India. And when we talk about India's philosophy and Indian perspective of education, right from the world first residential university, the more and more I read in the last few days about Nalanda, I tried to educate myself. What exactly is there in education? How 10,000 students from world over, how 2,000 acharya, what exactly was happening over there? How the Pali language and so much of treasure and so much of knowledge and so much of reservoir was there. The Indian philosophy is Vasudev Kutumbakam. And over here, the whole world is one family and all of us are together. So culture is given the first preference. Sanskriti, hamari jeene ki kala, hum kaun hai, main kaun hoon, main kya kar raha hoon, main kyun kar raha hoon, aur mujhse kaun karwa raha hai, ye sab cheezon ko jab main samajhne ki koshish karta hoon, to whatever values my parents have given me, my culture, my sanskriti plays very important role. Then comes our social norms, our etiquettes, manners, gesture, body language, humbleness, politeness, courtesy, our communication, verbal, non-verbal, whatever I talk about. Third part comes economics. So you see the priority. We have moved from the first ladder in the Western thought to the third part, that is economics. Pehle culture hai, phir social hai, aur phir hum economics par aate hain, jisko hum aaj modern management or modern education ki baat cheet karte hain. Aur chautha, of course, it's personal, what we have to take care of. एक पर्टिकुलर बच्चा एक पर्टिकुलर सब्जेक्ट क्यों पढ़ता है. लेट्स मूव अहेड. ड्यूरिंग द कोविड-19 लॉकडाउन पीरियड ऑल द रिस्पेक्टिव गवर्नमेंट्स इन देयर ओन वे इन डिफरेंट कंट्रीज दे आर ट्राइंग देयर लेवल बेस्ट टू यूज द टेक्नोलॉजी हाउ दे कैन इम्पार्ट एजुकेशन हाउ एजुकेटर्स कैन रीच देयर स्टूडेंट्स देयर चिल्ड्रन एंड वेर एवर द यूथ आर. कुछ लोग शहर में हैं, कुछ गांव में हैं, कुछ इंटीरियर में हैं, कुछ फार फ्लंग एरियाज में हैं. दिस मॉर्निंग आई वाज टॉकिंग टू कपल ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स इन तवांग एंड दे टोल्ड मी कि सर वी डोंट हैव इंटरनेट कनेक्टिविटी ओवर हियर. तो मैंने उनको बोला तुमने 4G ट्राई नहीं किया क्या जियो का. तो दे टोल्ड मी सर 4G नहीं आता है. सो दिस मॉर्निंग अ वेरी हम्बल रिक्वेस्ट ऑन सैटरडे मॉर्निंग टू द एंटायर गैलेक्सी ऑफ आवर गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया. Please give first preference to provide seamless connectivity to the youth. And of course, Honorable Prime Minister had been very kind. Finance Minister of India, she announced the other day that 12 different TV channels will be available for children very soon. We are from class 1 to class 12, they will have everything. Then of course, community radios. Apne aas paas mein FM radio, community radio, wahan se bhi education ka madhyam. Then your mobile phones. Then other electronic gadgets, how to make best use of them and how the education has to be imparted. That part is something very important. Education has to be relevant to our day-to-day life. Aaj maine Venerable डॉक्टर धमापिया जी को यही रिक्वेस्ट किया है कि आज हम बातचीत करने जा रहे हैं और पूरा वर्ल्ड से जितने हमारे साथ लोग जुड़े हैं, दोज आर फॉलोइंग द फिलॉसफी ऑफ द बुद्धिज्म और एनी अदर फिलॉसफी, वी आर द ब्रदर्स एंड सिस्टर्स ऑफ सेम गॉड, वी आर द चिल्ड्रन ऑफ सेम गॉड, जो भी आप हैं हम सब लोग स्टेक होल्डर हैं आज के एजुकेशन सिस्टम में। जो हम पढ़ा रहे हैं, जो करिकुलम है, जो एकेडमिक्स है, जो पढ़ाई हो रही है, उसका रोजमर्रा का जिंदगी में, डे टू डे लाइफ में क्या रेलेवेंस है? बच्चा जो पढ़ रहा है, क्या हम उसका सिलेबस कंप्लीट कर रहे हैं या उस बच्चे को हम प्रैक्टिकल कुछ दे रहे हैं? क्या वो जो बच्चा सीख रहा है उससे अपने घर के काम कर सकता है? इस लॉकडाउन पीरियड में आपने महसूस किया होगा, अगर आपके घर का नलका खराब हो जाता है तो क्या आपका बच्चा नल को रिपेयर कर सकता है? आपके घर की ट्यूबलाइट खराब हो जाती है, बल्ब खराब हो जाता है, आप बच्चा उसका ठीक कर सकता है? क्या बच्चे को ये पता है कि गर्मी, सर्दी, बारिश में और किस मौसम में कौन सी सब्जी उगती है, कौन सी वेजिटेबल जमीन के अंदर उगती है और कौन सी जमीन के ऊपर उगती है? ऐसी बहुत सारी चीजें हैं जो हमारी रोजमर्रा की लाइफ के साथ जुड़ी हुई हैं। लेट्स मेक एजुकेशन रेलेवेंट, लेट्स मेक एजुकेशन पार्ट ऑफ लिविंग एंड लाइफ, लेट्स एजुकेशन बी बेसिकली विद द मॉरल, सोशल, कल्चरल वैल्यूज, मेकिंग एजुकेशन रेलेवेंट। जो हमारी सीरीज है उसमें हम लाइफ मैनेजमेंट स्किल्स की बातचीत कर रहे हैं। एंड व्हेन आई वाज टॉकिंग टू माय इमीडिएट पास्ट प्रेसिडेंट इन लॉस एंजेलिस एंड ही टोल्ड मी लेट्स मूव अहेड, यू हैव टू मूव फ्रॉम स्किल्स टू कॉम्पिटेंसीज। तो लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, आज घर जाके यूट्यूब में देखिएगा व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन स्किल एंड कॉम्पिटेंसी, एंड देन यू विल कम टू नो वी शुड नॉट स्टिक ओनली टू स्किल्स, कि हम स्किल एम्पावर कर रहे हैं, हम स्किल दे रहे हैं, हम बच्चे की एजुकेशन के साथ बहुत सारी स्किल बच्चे को दे रहे हैं। व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन कॉम्पिटेंसी एंड अ स्किल, ये सब रेलेवेंस हैं। और इसमें गवर्नमेंट, हमारी एजुकेशन पॉलिसी, हमारे एजुकेटर्स, हमारे कॉर्पोरेट, हमारे पेरेंट्स और हमारे यूथ, सभी लोग उसके हिस्सा हैं एज फार एज एजुकेशन इज कंसर्न। दिस इज समथिंग वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग स्लाइड। यहां पर एक्सक्यूज मी, हम बात करते हैं क्या बच्चों को हर समय सुपरविजन चाहिए। डॉक्टर सुगाता मित्रा जो आईआईटी दिल्ली के हैं, एनआईआईटी के साथ भी रहे, उसके बाद अमेरिका गए, उसके बाद यूके में आए, बहुत सारी यूट्यूब के ऊपर इनकी वीडियोस हैं और इनका एक एवोल्यूशन लर्निंग का जो प्रोसेस है एनवायरमेंट का, उसको स्टडी करने में बहुत मजा आता है। और इनकी एक वीडियो है कैन किड्स टीच देमसेल्व्स, इसको जब आप यूट्यूब पर देखेंगे तो आपको लगेगा इन्होंने अपने गाँव में, अपनी जगह में जहां से बिलोंग करते हैं, कलकत्ता के पास किसी जगह पर इन्होंने एक दीवार के अंदर दो कंप्यूटर फिट कर दिए और दूर एक कैमरा लगा दिया, एंड बोथ द कंप्यूटर्स व्हिच ही फिटेड ओवर देयर, व्हाट ही डिड, द कैमरा रेज वर कमिंग ओवर देयर एंड देयर वाज अ रिकॉर्डिंग व्हिच वाज बीइंग डन, देयर वाज नो सुपरविजन, देयर वाज नो टीचर, देयर वाज नोबडी टू गाइड, एंड चिल्ड्रन वर लर्निंग एट देयर ओन, एंड आफ्टर 1 month 30 डेज व्हेन दे टुक आउट द एंटायर डाटा फ्रॉम दोस कैमरास, it was mind blowing what children can pick up at their own. So ladies and gentlemen, whosoever has come to this world, they have qualities, they have got creativity, let's not stop that creativity, let's not impose those exams and curriculum. Hum sab log ikatthe ho jaye, hum sab log pure education system ko empower kare aur badlav leke aaye, aisa accept mat kijiye jisme 48 स्कूल के एजुकेशन बोर्ड्स हैं, डिफरेंट तरीके की पढ़ाई है, बच्चे अलग अलग जगहों से आ रहे हैं और उस बच्चे पर इतना बोझ है, बाद में उसको आप कहते हैं कि 98% मार्क्स लेके आइए और तब आपको एडमिशन मिलेगा। क्यों हम इस तरीके का एक कॉबवेब क्रिएट कर रहे हैं, एक ऐसा वेब क्रिएट कर रहे हैं जो आर्टिफिशियल है, एंड इनसाइड वी ऑलरेडी नो दैट लास्ट ईयर सो मेनी सीट्स हैव गॉन वेकेंट इन मैनेजमेंट एंड इंजीनियरिंग, there were no takers, there were no students. So let's live with the reality. Let's not create artificial kind of a demand. Ladies and gentlemen, jab main Nalanda ko padhta hu, Takshila ko padhta hu, sab cheezon ko dekhta hu, India ki pehli ye jo residential university hai uske bare mein janne ki koshish karta hu, wahan ke darbaan ki bhi kya knowledge thi, wahan ka darbaan pehle interview leta tha, logon ko nishulk shiksha milti thi और बच्चों का रहना फ्री था, खाना फ्री था, पढ़ाई फ्री थी, रिसर्च का काम और सब्जेक्ट्स वहां के लेके चलो, भारत को पुनः विश्व गुरु बनना है। और डॉक्टर धमापिया जी के साथ मेरा यही रिक्वेस्ट है कि वर्ल्ड ओवर जितने भी बुद्धिस्ट के लोग हमारे जुड़े हुए हैं, जो बुद्धिज्म को फॉलो करते हैं, आप सबको सुबह नमन करते हुए, आई एम हम्बल स्टूडेंट ऑफ ऑल ऑफ यू, आई वॉन्ट टू लर्न समथिंग फ्रॉम यू, एंड आवर चेंबर, इंटरनेशनल चेंबर फॉर सर्विस इंडस्ट्री, इट वॉन्ट्स टू पिक अप द बेस्ट ऑफ थ्रेड्स, बेस्ट ऑफ एजुकेशन प्रैक्टिसेस, बेस्ट ऑफ एजुकेशन पॉलिसी, बेस्ट ऑफ पेडागॉजीज, बेस्ट ऑफ एंड्रोगॉजीज, बेस्ट ऑफ इनोवेशन, बेस्ट ऑफ रिसर्च, जो कुछ भी अवेलेबल है, पुनः भारत को विश्व गुरु बनना है और हमको भारत का सम्मान करना होगा। भारतीय शिक्षा मंडल से हमारे आदरणीय मुकुल कनिक्कर जी, जो मैं उनको जितना सुनता हूँ, सरस्वती है उनकी वाणी में, प्रभु ने उनको बहुत कृपा दी है, बहुत कृपा दी है। वो जो भी शब्द बोलते हैं, जो भी वाणी देते हैं, इतना कुछ उनसे आता है। और आजकल आप प्रोफेसर सत्येंद्र धीमान साहब को सुन रहे हैं। एक आदमी इंडिया से अमेरिका चला गया, लेकिन अमेरिका की किसी भी सभ्यता की किसी संस्कृति ने उनको छुआ तक नहीं। वो इंसान आज भी वही फिलॉसफी फॉलो कर रहा है जो इंडिया से वैल्यूज लेके गया, और वो हर संडे आपको मिलते हैं सुबह 9:30 बजे। धमापिया जी एक स्टेप आगे हो गए, क्योंकि 9:30 बजे शनिवार को आ रहे हैं सैटरडे को, और वो मिलेंगे आपको संडे को कल सुबह 9:30 बजे। लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, ये दोनों ट्राइगल आज की पढ़ाई लिखाई का, हमारी एजुकेशन की फिलॉसफी का निचोड़ है, जो सबको समझना बहुत ज्यादा जरूरी है। जब ट्राइंगल को आप उल्टा कर देते हैं, तो नीचे का जो एज है, जो शार्प है, वो टिक नहीं सकता, उसका कोई बेस नहीं है। एजुकेटर ऊपर है, पेरेंट्स ऊपर है, ऊपर से दबाव डाल रहे हैं, यूथ का बचपन छीन लिया। What's lost when we rush kid through childhood? We don't allow the children to grow in a natural way. We don't allow them to come out with their creativity, collaborative, happiness, music therapy. अरे बच्चे को मुस्कुराने दीजिए, बच्चे के चेहरे की मुस्कुराहट भी छीन ली। इतनी किताबें, इतना बड़ा बस्ता, सुबह रो के वो स्कूल जाता है। क्या फायदा है ऐसी एजुकेशन का? क्या फायदा है जहां बच्चा एंजॉय नहीं कर रहा? Education has to be entertaining. Education has to be fun. Education has to be stimulating. Education has to be rewarding. Education has to be part of day-to-day life, living. जो ऑक्सीजन जो श्वास मैं ले रहा हूँ, उसके अंदर से कहीं एजुकेशन की खुशबू आनी चाहिए. That is something which we are going to deliberate today. इसी ट्राइंगल को उल्टा कर दीजिए, यूथ को वहां रखिए जो वो टॉप पर होना चाहिए। पेरेंट्स और एजुकेटर हाथ जोड़ के प्रार्थना है, मान लीजिए, बच्चे की भी सुन लीजिए, बच्चा क्या चाहता है, व्हाट डज टुडेज यूथ वांट, प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड, मान लीजिए हमारी बात को। हम रिक्वेस्ट कर रहे हैं आपसे, 70 साल की उम्र में आप अपनी चीजों को इम्पोज बच्चों पे मत कीजिए। अरे भाई, जो मिलेनियल्स अभी पैदा हुए हैं, वो बच्चे गैजेट के साथ पैदा हुए हैं, वो एक इनोवेशन और टेक्नोलॉजी के साथ पैदा हुए हैं, उनके पास नए ऑपरेटर्स हैं, उनको उस चीज को निकारिए मत, उसको साथ लेके चलिए एजुकेशन में, और आप देखिए किस तरीके से सब कुछ होगा। यस, वी हैव टू ड्रॉ अ वेरी फाइन इक्विलिब्रियम एंड बैलेंस, दैट पार्ट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, वी विल वर्क आउट दैट। नाउ आप करेंगे कि पढ़ाई की ही बातचीत कर रहे हैं, एकेडमिक्स की बातचीत कर रहे हैं, बच्चे बोर हो जाते हैं। पहली बात तो मैं युवा पीढ़ी को कहना चाहता हूं, मैं कभी पढ़ाई की बातचीत नहीं करता, मैं फन की बातचीत करता हूँ, हैप्पीनेस की बातचीत करता हूँ, ह्यूमर की बातचीत करता हूँ, होलिस्टिक लिविंग की बातचीत करता हूँ। जो बच्चा कोई सब्जेक्ट पढ़ने के लिए हैप्पी नहीं है, उसका क्या फायदा है? आपने कई बार देखा होगा स्कूल में, कॉलेजेस में, यूनिवर्सिटीज में, इंस्टीट्यूशन में, किसी किसी टीचर की क्लास बहुत अच्छी लगती है, बहुत मजा आता है उसकी क्लास में, और किसी किसी टीचर की क्लास इतनी बोरिंग होती है कि आप कहते हो ये क्लास कब खत्म होगी यार, ये सब्जेक्ट कब खत्म होगा, कब ये जाएगा। और जब वो टीचर जाता है तो आप हाथ जोड़ते हो, हे प्रभु, हे ईश्वर, हे अल्लाह, हे परवरदिगार, हे जीसस, मैं तो तुम्हारे को नमन करता हूं कि थैंक गॉड दिस क्लास हैज गॉट ओवर। सो लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, हर सैटरडे को हम आपकी हैप्पीनेस की बातचीत करते हैं, आपकी हेल्थ की बातचीत करते हैं, आपकी वेलनेस की बातचीत करते हैं। आज सुबह हम लॉर्ड बुद्धा को फील करेंगे, लॉर्ड बुद्धा की वैल्यूज के साथ, उनके सर्मन्स के साथ, उनकी प्रीचिंग के साथ, उनकी वैल्यूज के साथ, और उनकी जो रेलेवेंस आज की एजुकेशन में है, उसकी बातचीत करेंगे। और शाम को 7 बजे मत भूलिएगा, फेसबुक पर लाइव आएंगे और आप लोगों के साथ जूम पर भी जुड़ेंगे, और हम आप लोगों के साथ आज की शाम बातचीत करेंगे जिसमें वेलनेस की बातचीत होगी और बहुत कुछ आपके रिलेटेड होगा. नाउ व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट, ये हमने आज 27th को जो मैंने आपसे बातचीत किया, इस वेबिनार को जो हम लेके चल रहे हैं, इसमें मेकिंग एजुकेशन रेलेवेंट की भी बातचीत कर रहे हैं, ग्लोबल कॉन्फ्लुएंस ऑफ एजुकेटर एंड मोटिवेटर्स की भी बातचीत कर रहे हैं, और इस सब को जब हम लेके चलेंगे तो ये वेलनेस की आज शाम की भी बातचीत है. सुबह हम आज लॉर्ड बुद्धा से मिलेंगे और बुद्धा को फील करेंगे और बुद्धा को रिक्वेस्ट करेंगे कि हमको अपनी शरण में ले लो. मैं तो आज रिक्वेस्ट करने वाला हूँ, इसलिए मैंने कपड़ा भी आज लॉर्ड बुद्धा का ही पहना है. मैं उनको आज फील करना चाह रहा हूँ, उनके बहुत नजदीक जाना चाह रहा हूँ और उन्हें कहूंगा कि अपने शरण में मुझे ले लीजिएगा आज की मॉर्निंग में. और शाम को वेलनेस के अंदर आप लोगों से बातचीत होगी. इंटरनेशनल वेबिनार आज हमारा 8वां प्रोग्राम है वेलनेस के ऊपर, आयुर्वेदा फॉर द ग्लोबल वेलनेस. नमो गंगे और ICSI मिलके, हमारा जो इंटरनेशनल चेंबर फॉर सर्विस इंडस्ट्री है, हम लोग मिलके आज की शाम आप लोगों के साथ बातचीत करेंगे. ये 5 एक्सपर्ट्स आ रहे हैं आज शाम को आपके साथ वेलनेस बात करने के लिए. यंग कैसे रहना है, हैप्पी कैसे रहना है, लाइफ में ह्यूमर कैसे लाना है. मैं हमेशा दमा पिया जी को यही कहता हूँ, मैं 70 साल की उम्र में एक 20 साल का बच्चा हूँ, मेरे अंदर जो एनर्जी है वो 20 साल की है. मैं कुछ सीखना चाहता हूँ, मैं हमेशा हैप्पी रहता हूँ, सुबह 4 बजे उठना चाहता हूँ और मुझे कोई थकावट नहीं है. आई एम सो हैप्पी, कम खाना चाहता हूँ, कम में रहना चाहता हूँ और परमात्मा से, लॉर्ड बुद्धा से आज बहुत कुछ सीखना चाहता हूँ आज की सुबह. कल सुबह संडे मॉर्निंग जब आप मिलेंगे तो कल से एक नई चीज स्टार्ट हो रही है लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन. अभी तक हमने एजुकेशन के रेलेवेंस पे बहुत सारी बातचीत की. यू विल हैव इंटरनेशनल स्पीकर टुमारो मॉर्निंग, यू विल हैव प्रोफेसर सत्येंद्र धीमान फ्रॉम द वुडबरी यूनिवर्सिटी फ्रॉम लॉस एंजेलिस, और कल का जो हमारा प्रोग्राम है लिविंग अ मीनिंगफुल लाइफ श्रीमद भागवत गीता इन टूडेज एजुकेशन. भागवत गीता के 18 चैप्टर हैं, हम 3 चैप्टर हर संडे को कवर करेंगे और क्योंकि हमारा लक्ष्य है कि 15 अगस्त तक 10 लाख टीचर्स और 10 लाख यूथ हमारे साथ इस प्रोग्राम में जुड़े हुए होंगे वर्ल्ड ओवर. पीपल दोज आर फ्रॉम वेयर एवर यू आर, वी मेक ए हम्बल रिक्वेस्ट टू यू, लेट्स बी पार्ट ऑफ दिस जर्नी टुगेदर ऑल ऑफ अस. हमने प्रोग्राम 5 जून को क्यों शुरू किया? व्हेन आई वाज गोइंग थ्रू कपल ऑफ डॉक्यूमेंट्स, आई रियलाइज्ड दैट 5th ऑफ जून को, क्योंकि हम सब लोग वर्ल्ड एनवायरनमेंट डे को ऑब्जर्व करते हैं, तो मैंने ये महसूस किया और रिसर्च से महसूस किया कि जो नेक्स्ट प्रोग्राम आने वाला है, जो नेक्स्ट डिफिकल्टी आने वाली है, वो बेसिकली आपको जो आने वाली है वो आपकी आने वाली है जल के बारे में. वो जो जल के बारे में आपकी प्रॉब्लम आने वाली है, जब उसकी हम बातचीत करेंगे, तो मैं लेके चलता हूं 5 जून को हमने अपनी ये यात्रा शुरू करी. तो 5 जून को वर्ल्ड एनवायरनमेंट डे था, 5th जून वी स्टार्टेड एंड वी आर गोइंग अप टू 15th ऑफ अगस्त 2020 इंडियाज इंडिपेंडेंस डे. सो इस जर्नी में आप भी हमारे साथ हैं, आप भी हमारी गाड़ी में आ जाइए, आप अच्छी सी सीट ले लीजिए, जिस सीट पर आप कंफर्टेबल है वहां आ जाइए, जिस स्टेशन पर उतरना चाहते हैं उतर जाइए. ये ट्रेन 15 अगस्त को अपने डेस्टिनेशन पर, पहले डेस्टिनेशन पर पहुंच रही है. तो इस पर्टिकुलर प्रोग्राम और प्रोसेस के अंदर जब हम लेके, प्लीज गो दैट साइड, जब हम लेके चलते हैं सारे प्रोग्राम को और सारी चीज को, सो दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट विच वी हैव टू वर्क आउट एंड वी हैव टू टेक केयर ऑफ, एंड दैट इज वेयर लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन 5 जून से 15 अगस्त तक का जो हमारा ये कार्यक्रम है मेकिंग एजुकेशन रेलिवेंट, इसी यात्रा में हम सब लोग इकट्ठे हैं. नाउ ग्लोबल वाटर कंजर्वेशन, पेरेंट्स, एजुकेटर्स एंड यूथ टुगेदर व्हेन वी टॉक विद ईच अदर, एट प्रेजेंट वी ऑल आर एट आवर होम्स, हम अपने अपने घरों में हैं और बच्चे अपने पेरेंट्स के साथ हैं. बच्चे जब अपने पेरेंट्स के साथ हैं, यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड, पेरेंट्स आई नो यू आर टेकिंग केयर ऑफ योर चिल्ड्रन द बेस्ट पॉसिबल वे. किसी के छोटे बच्चे होंगे, किसी के बड़े बच्चे होंगे, बच्चे अपने पीयर ग्रुप को मिस कर रहे होंगे, स्कूल को मिस कर रहे होंगे, लेकिन ये एक बहुत बहुमूल्य समय है. आप अपने बच्चों को बेसिकली वाटर कंजर्वेशन के बारे में अपने घर में ही बताइए कि पानी को कैसे बचाया जा सकता है, पानी को कैसे लेके चल सकते हैं. और उसके बाद जब स्कूल, कॉलेजेस, इंस्टीट्यूशन और ये सब चीजें खुल जाएंगी, तो हम इसको सेकेंड स्टेज पे लेके चलेंगे. और उसी के साथ साथ जब आपके वर्क प्लेसेस खुल जाएंगे तो हम वहां पर जाएंगे, आपकी फैक्ट्रीज हैं, आपके शॉपिंग मॉल्स हैं, आपके पिक्चर हॉल हैं, थिएटर्स हैं, पब्लिक प्लेसेस हैं, सब जगह हमें वाटर को कंजर्व करना होगा, बचाना होगा। वी हैव ऑल्सो सेंट ए रिक्वेस्ट टू ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर HRD गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया डॉक्टर रमेश पोखरियाल निशंक जी को, उन्हीं के साथ साथ हमने प्रकाश जावड़ेकर जी को और माननीय प्रधानमंत्री जी को भी एक पत्र भेजा है अपने चेंबर ICSI की तरफ से कि जिस तरह से टूरिज्म, हॉस्पिटैलिटी, एयरलाइंस, मीडिया एंटरटेनमेंट, ये सब एक वोकेशनल सब्जेक्ट हैं, तो हमको एक वोकेशनल सब्जेक्ट वाटर कंजर्वेशन का भी लेकर आना चाहिए, क्योंकि अगर पढ़ाई का प्रैक्टिकल रूप नहीं होगा तो क्या फायदा है। दैट पार्ट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट विच वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड। लास्ट 2.5 months, लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, lots of research has been done by our teams world over, kyunki hamara chamber 30 million NRIs ke sath deal karta hai, non resident Indians ke sath deal karta hai world over, wherever they are. When we talk about that, ladies and gentlemen, holistic living ka jo ecosystem hai usme pichle 2.5 months mein jo research hui hai hamare research scholars ki different countries ke andar, to unhone humko ye triangle bana ke bheja hai कि सबसे पहले बेसिक चीज है खाने के ऊपर, बेसिक फूड के ऊपर, बेसिक नेसेसिटीज के ऊपर, हमारी जो एग्रीकल्चर और एनिमल हस्बेंड्री है अपने घर की छत के ऊपर, अपने घर के किचन गार्डन में, अपने आसपास, बेसिकली आप वो सब्जियां उगाइए जिन सब्जियों से बेसिकली आपका निर्वाह हो सकता है। उसी के साथ साथ सेकेंड पार्ट है कि आप हेल्थ और वेलनेस पर ध्यान दीजिए। अपनी वेलनेस पर अगर आप ध्यान देंगे, अगर आप दिमागी तौर पर ठीक रहेंगे, आपका मस्तिष्क ठीक रहेगा, एंजाइटी नहीं आनी, स्ट्रेस नहीं आना, डिप्रेशन नहीं आना, कोई गलत चीज नहीं करनी, आपको अच्छा सोचना है, पॉजिटिव सोचना है, पॉजिटिव एटीट्यूड रखना है, आप जहां पर हैं उस चीज को लेके चलिए, देन यू फाइंड ये COVID-19 भी गुजर जाएगा। बहुत सारे प्रॉब्लम लाइफ में आती है, कितने सारे लोग तो इसमें से निकल के ठीक भी हो जाएंगे, उनको नहीं पता लगेगा कि उनको COVID-19 के अंदर कुछ प्रॉब्लम हुई थी, क्योंकि हम लोगों का, इंडियंस का इम्यून सिस्टम बहुत स्ट्रांग है, और अपनी इम्यूनिटी को बूस्ट करने के लिए मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ आयुष ने आपको टाइम टू टाइम बहुत सारी चीजें बताई हैं। तीसरा पार्ट आता है एजुकेशन का। एजुकेशन में हमको समझना होगा, एजुकेशन विल नेवर गेट बैक टू जनवरी फरवरी मोड वेयर वी वर इनसाइड द क्लासरूम। प्लीज रिमेंबर दैट nobody knows how long the pandemic would be there, nobody knows when the first vaccine will come, nobody knows who is going to get the first vaccine, nobody knows what would be the cost of that vaccine, nobody knows how the world, and nobody knows, we pray to Almighty that this entire thing should not bounce back and comes back again. Nobody knows, no research is authentic today. So thereby niche ki baat samajh lijiye, sustainable development, atmanirbharta, जो ऑनरेबल प्राइम मिनिस्टर ऑफ इंडिया नरेंद्र मोदी जी ने उस दिन कहा कि आत्मनिर्भर होना होगा, यू हैव टू बिकम सेल्फ डिपेंडेंट, इट इज बेटर टू ईट लेस, लिव हेल्दी, थिंक पॉजिटिव, नो डिप्रेशन, नो एंजाइटी, नो स्ट्रेस। हर एक बच्चे को, हर एक पेरेंट को ये बात हमको बोलना है। प्रॉब्लम्स आएंगी, डिफिकल्टीज आएंगी, दे आर पार्ट ऑफ लाइफ, पेन वुड बी देयर, देयर इज नो प्रॉब्लम, बट वी हैव टू ओवरकम दैट पर्टिकुलर पेन। बुद्धा की फिलॉसफी में बहुत सारी इस तरीके की चीजें, आज धम्मपिया जी हमारे साथ बातचीत करेंगे, और जो B2B पहले होता था, बिजनेस टू बिजनेस, नाउ इट विल बी नोन बैक टू बेसिक्स, सो दैट इज समथिंग वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। नाउ लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, आई विश टू शेयर विद ऑल ऑफ यू वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट स्लाइड, दिस इज एप्लीकेबल टू ईच वन ऑफ अस, एंड दिस इज नॉट माई रिसर्च और माई सेइंग और माई चेंबर रिसर्च, बट आई रेड अ पर्टिकुलर बुक and human mind. When we study, the more and more we study, whatsoever human mind can conceive and believe, remember that, I repeat it for you, whatsoever human mind can conceive and believe, it can achieve. Once you conceive the idea and once you believe you can do it, nothing can stop you in this planet. Almighty the God has made all of us so wonderful. This mental toughness and mental robustness is so important, you got to understand. Let's come together for global education empowerment. It's something very important which we have to understand. International Chamber for Service Industry which is linked with all the non-resident Indian and PIOs and my brothers and sisters in foreign countries, in different countries, world over, those come and join our program every day. You have got a website over here, www.icsiindia.in. You also have got an email ID over here to send your suggestions. That is innovation@icsi.asia. I repeat it for you, innovation@icsi.asia. If anybody out of us is interested to become a panelist for this particular Buddhism series, you want to be a panelist, you want to be a speaker, you want to share your thought process, you can send at innovation@icsi.asia. And also, Venerable Dr. Dhammapiya ji had been very kind, the Secretary General of the International Buddhist Confederation. You can send an email to him at dr, that stands for Dr. dr underscore Dhammapiya, dhammapiya @yahoo.com. I repeat it for my benefit. It's a dr underscore dhammapiya @yahoo.com. And we have got also WhatsApp numbers down below. First two numbers are of ICSI and second two numbers are of Dr. Dhammapiya ji. We have given all the details to you over here so that all of us together, ladies and gentlemen. So with these words, I once again extend a very, very hearty welcome to Venerable Dr. Dhammapiya ji. Hearty welcome to you. What a pleasure to have you this morning, Saturday morning. You have joined us and we wish to learn from you and learn from all the brothers and sisters, those who have joined us wherever they are, world over. Those of us who have joined us on the Facebook, we are indebted to you. Dr. Gulshan Sharma's page, kindly switch on your watch party. Kindly switch on wherever you can share with your friends, your brothers, sisters, and of course, the whole globe is one family. All of us together, while praying Lord Buddha this morning, I extend a very hearty welcome to Dr. Dhammapiya ji.
Namo tassa bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhassa. Namo tassa bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhassa. Namo tassa bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhassa. Buddham saranam gacchami. Dhammam saranam gacchami. Sangham saranam gacchami. Dutiyampi tatiyampi. Buddham saranam gacchami. Dhammam saranam gacchami. Sangham saranam gacchami. A very good morning and happy morning and metta, compassion, loving kindness and the blessings of Triple Gem to all the venerable monks, nuns, upasakas, upasikas, laypersons, viewers from all over the world today. May you all be free from suffering, danger, illness, and have a healthy and peaceful life. As Dr. Gulshan Sharmaji has said, we are having a journey. The journey has started, this particular journey of global education empowerment or making education relevant. This particular journey, it started on 5th of June on the World Environment Day, and it will go on till 15th of August, the Independence Day of India. And all these days on this platform, the webinar, there have been and there will be series of talks, discussions, and knowledge sharing by eminent personalities from different fields, specialists in different fields from all over the world coming together. The coming togetherness is a very important concept. When we have knowledge in different fields, we are specialized in different fields, we are expert in different area, when the knowledge come together, when the strength, energy of human mind, the human knowledge, human wisdom come together with a positive attitude, very important, with a positive attitude, positive vision, positive outlook, and commitment, and with a feeling of service, to serve the world, to serve the humanity, to serve all living beings. If we come together with this kind of attitude and vision and worldview, definitely we can really do wonders, and we can overcome any kind of challenges that we are facing. It is either of this coronavirus kind of thing, or social, emotional, mental, economic, whatever kind of challenges or difficulties, problems we are having, when this knowledge, the pool of knowledge, the reservoir of knowledge can be brought together. And if we make use of our knowledge available with us globally, collectively, definitely we can overcome every difficulty, problem, and we can create a better place. I call it, as we have in the Pure Land Buddhism, the pure land on earth. That means heaven on earth. So on this journey, I would like to thank Dr. Gulshan Sharmaji, especially to you, as you are my elder brother. You are also wearing similar kind of color now today, because you are moderating the session on Buddha's teaching. I'm thankful to you for including a session every Saturday to share the knowledge, the Dhamma, the wisdom that is available in Buddhism or Buddha Dhamma. It is very important that we understand the journey of life. What we are taking this journey is only a little journey from 5th June to 15th August. But if we see the whole life is a journey from the time we are born till that moment we take the last breath, this B to D, birth to death, the span, the time is a journey. And how the journey for us to be will depend on how we understand the life, how we understand things around us, how we understand, get knowledge on the realities around us. So this journey of life is not only for a human being. This journey is for all living beings. This journey is even for the world. Even world also has its own lifespan. It is not eternally the same. It undergoes modification, changes, creation and recreation and destruction. So it is the law of nature. And in the journey of life, in the journey of making education relevant, empowering education globally, I would invite all the peace-loving people, good-hearted people, knowledge seekers to come together and provide your knowledge and wisdom to make this series a success, and not only success, also fruitful and happiness and peace bearing. Because we understand the success does not necessarily entail or give rise to happiness. A successful person, not necessarily a happy person. But a happy person is definitely a successful person. So we have to have happiness first. One who is happy is always full of positive energy, good energy, and all the positive things he bears. And one who works with all the good positive qualities and energy, definitely the person cannot be a failure. The success, the definition of success may be different, but whatever small thing that a person does is for the person a success, because he or she completes it, whatever is the target. So today, we are having the topic that is the relevance of Buddha's teaching or Buddha Dhamma on today's education. We'll be having the series of talk on this theme starting from 4th of July, which is a very auspicious day for everyone. For the Buddhist,
sir, we lost the signal in between. 4th of July ke baad aapka signal chala gaya. Ek bar repeat kar dijiye.
Acha, yeah, okay. What I'm saying is, we are going to have this series of talk starting from 4th of July, which is very important and auspicious day. The first auspicious day for the Buddhists and for everyone is the Vaishakha Purnima, or the full moon day of Vaishak, the day when Siddhartha Gautama became fully awakened one, self-actualized one, fully enlightened one, and the day he was born, and the day he took Mahapurinirvana, that is birth and becoming fully awakened, becoming Buddha and passing away. All the three important events took place on one full moon day, that is Vaishakha Purnima, which is understood and celebrated with much of auspiciousness and reverence, the full moon day of Vaishakha. So also this Ashadi Purnima, the full moon day of Ashara, is equally important. And it's very important for us, because after being fully awakened, fully enlightened, Sammasambuddha, whatever knowledge and wisdom, jnana, panya, the Buddha has achieved or got, it was communicated on this Ashara Purnima, that is coming this year, 2020, on 4th of July. So this is very auspicious day. So we'll be having the starting of our series of talk on this theme, the relevance of Buddha's teaching on today's education from Ashara Purnima. We invite panelists and speakers, whoever want to be panelists or speak on this theme, kindly write to us with your details. We'll be trying to include. And we know the Buddhists all over the world. We have more than 500 million Buddhist population in the Asian, what they call ASEAN or Asian, ASEAN and Southeast Asia country. Nowadays, the number of Buddhist or the Buddhist learners or those who are interested in the teachings of the Buddha in the West, that is Europe, in America, Australia, New Zealand, is growing very fast. So the number cannot be limited to the ASEAN or Southeast Asia alone. There are people in large number who are taking interest to know and learn and practice the teachings of the Buddha, even in other parts of the world, including Africa, South Africa also. So I invite everyone from all over the world, kindly write to us, drop a message if you're interested to be a speaker or panelist on this series. So we'll be having the talk, the series from 4th of July. Then we'll have next is, it's every Saturday in the morning, Indian Standard Time, 9:30 to maybe 10:30 or 11. Starting from 4th July, Ashari Purnima, the auspicious day, will be starting. Then 11th July, 18th July, 25th July, 1st August, and 8th August. So we would be requesting panelists or speakers from different countries. We would like the panelists and the eminent masters and scholars, both lay scholars as well as the Sangha members, venerable monks and nuns. At least we should have one lay person, lay speaker, and one monk or nun speaker, at least I'm saying every Saturday. It will be very good to share the knowledge or the wisdom of Buddhism from different traditions, some Pali tradition, they may be from Tibetan or Mahayana tradition, they may be from the Taiwanese and Chinese tradition, maybe say Korean tradition, and we have the Sanskrit tradition, and then Japanese Zen Buddhism, different traditions are there. We invite from all traditions, please come and join us to enlighten, to empower the education through Buddha's teaching. And it is for the people who may not have the proper understanding of who is a Buddha. I think we have to first understand that. Because we think, or many people think, the Buddhism is a religion as it is understood. Whether the Buddha has started a separate religion as such, that is the question we have to ask. When we talk about religion, then we definitely understand it is a faith system, having faith. And this faith is unshakable faith on some almighty or super being who is considered to be omniscient, all-knowing, and omnipotent, capable of doing anything, everything, and also omnipresent, who can be present, who is present everywhere. So that is the gunas or the qualities attributes attributed to the concept we have called God or Ishwara or Bhagavan or Allah, whatever name we give. I mean, supreme, that is. So, to take Buddha in the same category, like those almighty gods, may not be appropriate. That's what we have to try to understand first. Because the Buddha was born as a human being. Buddha was born as a human being. And this term Buddha is not actually referring to a person called Buddha. That's what we have to understand first. If my name is Dr. Dhammapiya, say when Dhammapiya, so when you say Dhammapiya, it refers to me. And if it is Dr. Gulshan Sharmaji, then it refers to the person called Gulshan Sharmaji, like Gulshan Sharma, like that. But when we say Buddha, it doesn't refer or speak of a person. A person, it's not a name. That's what we have to understand. When we talk about Jesus, Jesus Christ, I do not know whether it is something else other than the name of a person. When we talk about Muhammad, for example, I do not know whether there is something else other than the name of the person. Definitely teachings, all this will be there. But when we talk about the Buddha, we are not talking about a person by name. Buddha is not a name or the person. The person who became Buddha, whom we know now, was known as Siddhartha Gautama. The actual name was Siddhartha Gautama. And there have been other Buddhas as well before this Siddhartha Gautama. That means the Buddha is a state of achievement. We call it fully awakened state. In Pali, it is called Samma Sambuddha. It's not only Buddha, it's called Samma Sambuddha. Means one who has attained the Samyak Sambuddhi, full enlightenment, full realization. And when a person, either it can be Dr. Gulshan Sharmaji or Mr. X, Y, Z, or any other person in that matter, when becomes a Buddha, because we all have Buddha nature in us, when we can fully actualize, awaken the Buddha nature, and become fully enlightened, then we or the person will be also called the Buddha. So whenever a person becomes a Buddha, the Buddha, whoever the person, will teach or will talk about the same truth, it is said. Because the truth is a universal and eternal. So when I become enlightened, suppose, I mean any Mr. X become enlightened, a Buddha, and Mr. Y become Buddha, or Mr. or some other X, Y, Z become Buddha, the three Buddhas will not speak three things or three truths. They all will speak the same truth, but the way of explanation, storytelling, examples may be different, but they all will be talking about the same truth in the same way. That is what actually the Buddha we have to understand is not an almighty person, not an almighty God as such, but he has, the Buddha has all the qualities. This is what we have to understand. Though Buddha is not considered to be an almighty, but the Buddha has all the gunas and qualities. Though he is a human being, or he was a human being, of what we expect of the Almighty, which are those? It is called abhijnana. Abhijnana. In India, we have our Indian language. Either it is Sanskrit or Pali or Magadhi or Prakrit or Hindi or Gujarati, you'll find Marathi, there is Bengali or Assamese, Uriya. There is some similarity in our language. And it is called Gyan or Jnana. Jnana or Gyan. Gyan or Jnana. So Gyan or Jnana is a term difficult to translate comprehensively into English. So we have the term in English, which is closer to the Indian concept of the term jnana, is knowledge. But what Buddha has achieved is not mere jnana, not mere gyan, not mere knowledge. It is called abhijnana. Abhijnana means higher form of knowledge. If jnana or jnana is knowledge, abhi, you add your prefix abhi, it becomes the highest form of knowledge, the highest, the supreme. And what are those highest form of knowledge? That whoever becomes a fully Sammasambuddha, fully awakened one, has developed this jhana or knowledge. That is, number one, iddhi vidha jnana, means iddhi vidha jnana. This iddhi vidha jnana is like we call, in case of Almighty God, omnipotent, capable of doing everything, anything, right? So the Buddha had attained that jnana, that power. Some people may call it psychic power or extraordinary power, whatever you may name it. But in Pali, in Indian language, in Sanskrit, we call iddhivida jnana or iddhivida jnana, where the Buddha can do many things which is not possible by the normal human being. Number one, jnana, abhijnana. Number two is dibba sota. That means clairaudience. Or you have, or the Buddha can hear, can know the sound or the language of any living being, not only this Pali or English or Sanskrit or Hindi or Gujarati or Prakrit or some other spoken language by the human beings. But Buddha has the capacity or the jnana where Buddha can understand the language spoken by birds, by animals, by insects. And not only these animals, insects, and human beings, but it is said, deva manusyanam. Even the non-human deva, the deities, we call demigods or deities, the non-human forms of existence. See, that means whatever qualities we are attributing to the Almighty God, you find those qualities are present in case of the Buddha or the Vid Buddha. It's dibhasota. Then next jhana is seto pariyayo jhana. That is a kind of clairvoyance, or like the Buddha has the capacity to know what is going on in the mind of other person. You see, knowing or capable of reading what the other person is thinking. The other person is not necessarily human being, any living being. In the life of Buddha, there were many cases where Buddha had to tell the other person when the person was thinking something wrong about, and Buddha had to intervene, and Buddha had to demonstrate something, and then that person was shocked. How could Buddha know what he was thinking about Buddha or something else? So like that, there were many cases. But Buddha never used his power. He did not allow his disciples to use such powers unnecessarily. I mean, not to use at all. You have achieved something, you got it, keep it with you. And only if necessary for good, for happiness, it may be in some way put into use, but not to show others that you have this thing, that thing. That's what the Buddha has instructed to his disciples, and Buddha did not use. Number three is citta parijñāna, the capability of knowing the mind of other person. Then fourth is pubbe nivasa nusati jñāna. That means the Buddha had developed the faculty of mind, as our Dr. Gulshan Sharmaji was saying, the limitless, infinite capacity of the mind. Once you think and believe that you can achieve. See, that is what the Buddha has shown as an example, living example, that these would be Buddha, Bodhisattva, that time he was not Buddha. Millions, billions, billions of years ago, you can say, we call it Asankhya Kappa. Many, many years, thousands, millions, billions of years ago, when he was only a normal human being, he took the determination in front of the other Buddha, Dipankara Buddha, and he took like a vow, we call vow, I think vow, that I will, I mean vow in the sense that Dipankara Buddha only gave him the blessings, that and he, it became like a vow for him, determination, strong determination, that he would become a Buddha, you see. That means at that time, what he taught, ascetic sumedha, he was ascetic sumedha at that time, in that life. So he took determination that he would become fully enlightened person, and he got blessing or the vow from the Dipankara Buddha at that time, millions, billions, 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 trillions of years ago. And that particular mind, see, volition mind of to become Buddha, he started fulfilling those qualities and became fully enlightened, awakened Buddha during this world circle, whom we know as Gautama the Buddha. That means the Buddha had developed the pubbe nivasa nusati jnana, that is, he could recollect his past lives, that is not one life, 1, 2, 300, thousands, lakhs, millions, billions. I mean, as long as many as the Buddha wanted to know of the past lives, he could recollect and know each, every detail of that particular life. That's why Buddha was saying one day to his disciples, you know, if you collect this ocean, the water in the ocean, Arabian Ocean, Bay of Bengal Ocean, whatever Pacific Ocean, the water of these oceans, the water in the ocean in the world will be less than the tears I have shed. The tears I have shed during my life in the past. Now you can think how much suffering I have undergone through. Not in one life. You can see, compare how many lives he might have spent, and he has undergone suffering and pains, and he had shed tears. And if that tears is collected, that would be much, much more than the water in the ocean. Now you see, that's what the Buddha could see. They recollect all those lives. That jnana, abhijnana, is called pubbe nivasa nusati jnana. Then we have fifth. Fifth is dibba chakhu. That is, it is, I think this one only, I think clairvoyance, I don't know in English what is called. That is the jnana, the knowledge, the highest form of knowledge, where the Buddha can know, or has the capacity of the mind to know, the lives of other people also. The previous lives, the past lives of other people. First one is knowing one's own life. Then The second one is, that is the Dibba Chakku, is by using the Dibba Chakku like a lens or whatever you call that. We have now new terms, Durbin, what do you call it? Binocular. This is like Buddha's binocular kind of thing. I mean, he has that vision, that faculty to know the past lives of other people, not one, two, three lives, thousands lives, millions lives, the past lives of other people, if Buddha wanted to see. But it is not like Buddha, it will be appearing in the eyes of the Buddha, in the vision of Buddha, not like that. The mind has to focus on that, then it will appear. Like how we switch on the TV or the different channels of TV, and it appears, something like that. When that particular faculty channel is opened, then the Buddha could see the lives of those people. It's called Dibba Chakku. Not only about the lives of other people, the Buddha could see the world cycles, the different kind of different aspects of cosmos. That's what Buddha has said, sahasra sahasra chakkavala. That means it is not only one world, it is not only one life, it is not only one solar system. Buddha has said there are innumerable, uncountable world system, world cycles. And when people ask Buddha, why don't you tell them, explain about these things? Then Buddha said very clearly, my purpose of becoming a Buddha is not to explain, to teach you the world of different galaxies and solar systems, the farming or this thing or that thing. That is available in the world. You can learn. But my purpose is to give you the knowledge, the jnana, the wisdom, show the path where you can lead a happy life, a peaceful life, and overcome the suffering, the torments, depressions, sorrow, lamentation that the human community, the people are undergoing through. And it is not only a temporary solution. The solution, the path, the medicine I'm going to give, the Dhamma, is a permanent solution. Anybody whoever walks on the path of the Dhamma or the takes the medicine of Dhamma can completely overcome and come out from the cycle of the suffering. That is what my purpose of becoming a Buddha. So if you want to learn more philosophy, history, or the knowledge system, it is available in the world. You may go to those who are expert in that. But when you come to me, you'll be coming to me if you're interested to be happy, to lead a happy life. So we should go to Buddha to lead a happy life, right? To lead a happy life and also to make the world happy. Then, the six is asavakkhaya jnana. That is the knowledge or wisdom where the Buddha has developed the capacity to know whether a person has fully eradicated the intoxicating dimensions of life, or the intoxicants we call defilements. I mean, the conditions which are responsible for making human beings suffer or miserable, the conditions or the elements which propel the continuity of human life continuum. So these are the abhijnana that the Buddha, whoever is a Buddha, will achieve this kind of knowledge. So what we understand now is, when we talk about Buddha, we have to understand Buddha as a human being, having possessed and developed, awakened, achieved all this abhijnana, higher form of knowledge, which is now, you can see, all-inclusive. That is why the Buddha is called Samma Sambuddha. There is nothing left to be learned or achieved. It's a fully like 100% achievement completion. It's Samma Sambuddha, right? So now, when we ask the question, who could have been the Buddha's teacher? Yes, for me too, I have my parents' teachers, my teachers in the school, college, university, for you also, like that. So whether Buddha had such teachers, yes. Before becoming the fully awakened person, the Buddha had learned all the traditional all the traditional arts, crafts, and then martial art, whatever we call that, this knowledge system, there during that period, under different rishis, munis, we have, I think, Gurukul or something like that, right? Where these different shishyas, disciples go to some rishis, munis. So the Siddhartha Gautama had gone to different masters at that time of his time before he renounced the world, right? That means he has learned from different masters, fine. But when Siddhartha Gautama became fully enlightened person, he became fully enlightened not because somebody has taught him. This is the point we have to understand. It is not the Buddhahood or the knowledge of Buddha Vijnana is not a theoretical transferring knowledge. It is not that I taught you about this functioning of the solar system or the functioning of the water or some other thing. It's not that kind of knowledge. That's why the Buddha became Buddha by self-effort. That's why I call self-awakened one, right? Self-awakened one. So Buddha became Buddha by self-effort. And we all are requested or asked to work by ourselves, but we can take guidance from our masters and teachers, but we have to work for our own development, for our own effort. This is the main focus of the Buddha, that every human being has to work for oneself and for others, please. Every human being has to work for oneself and for others. Here comes the question of responsibility. Buddha clearly said, there may be different conditions responsible for whatever is happening, but we as human beings are the number one responsible people, responsible persons, whatever is happening around us. We are not to attribute all the bad things, unpleasant things, destructions, all things happening to some Ishwara, God, Allah, Bhagavan. No, not to attribute to them. For Buddha, definitely there may be some conditions in the cosmic energy, cosmic world, in the cosmic laws, but we are responsible for whatever is happening because we act either positively or negatively, either with positive mind or negative mind. When we collectively act with negative mind, the world becomes a negative world. When we all collectively act positively with good mind, love, and compassion, the world will become a positive world, right? Okay, I'll not take much time because I am not to give a long talk. Just I thought, just to touch on the Buddha, who was the Buddha, who is Buddha, because many people have some misunderstanding. People say Lord Buddha, Bhagavan Buddha, all this fine. If you want to have a respect for Buddha, if you definitely, we all have such deep respect for Buddha, we place him in highest. So we call Lord Buddha, Bhagavan Buddha, whatever, it's okay. But we have to have clarity in our understanding that Buddha means what, or who was the Buddha, or who is the Buddha, right? So now the relevance of Buddha's teaching. What Buddha has taught. I think it will take a long time. I'll not talk today on what Buddha has taught. It will and then take two, three lectures, actually. You know? So what I would like to tell in a nutshell is, whatever Buddha has taught is from his own experience of life and from his experience of the life in the past. You see, Buddha teaching is not only based on the knowledge he has received from his masters, from his teachers, or from this particular life. But when you see his teachings, and he used to relate different incidences, different happenings, even in the past also. That means the teachings of the Buddha is taught for the past, taking knowledge from the past and the present knowledge, and with a vision and understanding of the future also. That means three kala, three time is included, the past and the present and the future. That means it's all inclusive, holistic teaching, right? And the Buddha has said, whatever I am teaching, whoever follows it one has to follow, one has to act. And like the example he has given is, the water in the ocean, from wherever you pick up, it has only one taste, that is the salty taste. It will be salty, saline, that is nature of the ocean water. So also, the teaching I have been giving with my abhijnana knowledge, the higher form of knowledge, and my teaching, this Dhamma, whoever practices, whoever follows, will give nothing but happiness and peace. The taste of the Buddha's teaching is happiness, peace, tranquility, and harmony. But one has to follow and practice in one's life. So this teaching of the Buddha is not to be taught like the transferring of knowledge from book to book or from one person to another. This is what we have to understand. It is not classroom knowledge. Buddha's education is not classroom education. Theoretical teaching is okay, but it has to be put into one's own life. So living education, right? So that we have to understand. We have to talk on some other day, because today is quite long. And I'll say the other words of the Buddha. It says, whoever practices the teachings of the Buddha in reality, not necessarily you and me or any other person, even Deva, because Buddha word says it is for bhojana hitaya, bhojana sukhaya, loka no kampaya, deva manusanam. It is for the happiness, welfare, benefit of human beings and non-human. Deva deities for everyone, right? So the Buddha says, adi kalyanam, which we have spoken last Sunday, the Buddha's teaching, whoever follows, has this quality, this impact. That is adi kalyanam, majhe kalyanam, antime kalyanam, or pariyusana kalyanam, same thing. Sattang sabhyanjanam, kevala paripunnam, parisuddham, brahmachariyam, pakaset. That's what Buddha has said. Means whoever follows the path of the Buddha, the Buddha's Dhamma, or his learning, it has to give the mangal or the good in the beginning, in the middle, at the end. So whoever is following or calling oneself a Buddhist, if our life experience is not giving happiness and the good, then there is something wrong in our following the teachings of the Buddha. We have to understand that. Once we take the medicine properly, medicine is actually verified. There is no defect in the medicine, right? So only thing is we have to take it properly and proper time. Whether we have to see whether it's the medicine is properly taken, because the medicine of the Buddha has no expiry date, eternal. So in today's world, the teaching of the Buddha can be really helpful, because it talks about mainly the habit of a person. It's called sila, the conduct or habit of the person. Then it talks about the mental state, samadhi, tranquility of the mind, and also panya, the knowledge, the higher form of knowledge that one can achieve, where once you have achieved this higher form of knowledge, then you automatically remove those defilements or the aspects of your behavior which make you unhappy. So in today's world also, when the Buddha's teaching is taken into our classroom teaching, where after making the students understand in the classroom and then put into practice as it is required, they understand in the field of mental health, physical health, environmental health, social health, and global spiritual health, as we are suffering now from different kind of the diseases, difficulties can be achieved. I hope next time, next Sunday, Ashari Purnima, we'll be having eminent scholars and speakers to speak the other aspects of Buddha's Dhamma. So it's just, I spoke only one fraction of, you know, there's so many things that need to be spoken. How I have not gone how the Buddha's teaching to be implemented, not in the classroom or in the life. Just it is an introduction. Thank you so much, Gulshanji. I think we have taken a long time.
No. It's such a pleasure. I was trying to assimilate each and every word of yours. Now, Dhammapiyaji, one more request I would like to make. Yeah. You have a vision to set up an international level university where from world over the people should come and they should do the research. They should take studies and they should do everything. What exactly is that vision? Can you briefly talk about that? It would be very kind of you, because I'm getting a lot of requests on my Facebook, and people want to know this morning from you, because that is one of the agendas. I just wanted that some of my corporate friends, those have joined from world over, they wish to know what exactly is your vision and what do you want there and how it's coming up and how we are proceeding and how we wish to support that vision.
Okay. The Buddha's teaching is basically a knowledge system, education system. It is not the faith system as such.
Okay.
Not a faith system as such. Of course, faith is there, Shraddha is there, but not faith with blind something, with blindness. Faith with understanding and clarity is called Shraddha. Right.
Okay.
It is there. So if we see in the past, every Buddhist monastery used to be education center, learning center for people. It is like Indian system, you see, as we are in India, where the children from different families, they used to go to Buddhist monasteries and learn different art, crafts, teaching, things which are useful in their life. And we had the best example is Nalanda, Takshashila, Vikramashila, Udantapuri, such kind of universities where thousands of people used to study from all parts of India and from different parts of the world, and where the acharyas, the masters, the teachers were in large numbers also, and well-qualified teachers. And it is known fact to all how the Nalanda University, Takshashila, Vikramashila, they fell into the hands of the destroyers. Everybody knows it is the historical fact. We are not antagonistic against anybody, but what is the truth, the fact, we have to state it, right? So after demolition and destruction of those universities, we have not been able to revive Indian knowledge system. And we have been told in the sense we find in our these writings, the Nalanda University, when it was burned down, put to ash, it burned for almost three to six months. We feel so much really, I don't know what to say, this such kind of knowledge, the treasure reservoir we lost, right? Somehow, whatever we are having, the travelers from different neighboring countries and our own internal masters, somehow some of them have preserved part of that which they had, not in the Nalanda University, that we are having information or the knowledge today with us. So it is the idea to revive this Indian knowledge system once again, like what Nalanda University had, and to share it for creating a good, very well-established knowledge system based on in the line of the Nalanda, Vikramashila, Takshashila of the past, incorporating the new knowledge system also. Because we have to talk about the life, the living. So it's not only studying of the scriptures and those things, but we have to have other areas of subject which are modern so that we can generate knowledge, we can generate skills, we can generate competency, as you are saying, definitely. So all these things are kept in mind. And there had been a request, to be frank with you today. Some people ask me, why do you need to start a new university concept like that? Because already Nalanda University is coming up in Rajgir, right? Which government of India has allocated a big fund. But the fact or the real picture is like this. The Buddhist world, they see actually who is there behind the university, who are the people running the university, because they want to have faith, Shraddha, right? And in the system, you see, in the Buddhist system, when some Buddhist masters and Buddhist monks are running the university, they have faith, right? They have faith, Shraddha, or confidence. When the administrators or the bureaucrats that run the university, they have faith of different kind. So they definitely, they'll be going there learning and these things. But the spiritual, devotional, all this kind of thing, the commitment, they get it when it is being run by the Buddhist masters. That is why from global Buddhist community, I have been requested that wherever it is not in Tripura or where or here or there, at least some Buddhist, Indian Buddhist, they request Indian Buddhist. They are saying that all the ASEAN countries, 10 countries of ASEAN and Southeast Asian countries, they got Buddha Dhamma from India. And they are very, very much grateful to India. They say India is their like homeland, because the teachings of the Buddha is from India. That is why they wanted to repay gratitude, give back something to India. That's what they are saying. How to give back? What do you want from us? They're asking like that. So we do not want anything from them, right? So we told them how the Buddha's knowledge system was strong in India. If you can kindly help us to reestablish the Indian, the Buddhist knowledge system in India again, it will be great. So that we can collaborate with all other Buddhist universities in the world and with Nalanda University also. It is not that we'll be competing with Nalanda University, not like that. We'll be working with Nalanda University, which government has started. And I would like the government to come forward and take this university actually. I mean, we need many universities, many good centers, right? So in this regard, the government of Tripura has issued an LOI giving permission to start the university under certain conditions, where we need to have actually a good amount of fund, definitely minimum 100 crores. Means I think how many millions? Maybe 1,000 million? I don't know how many. 100 crores means something like that, okay. Indian rupees. Yeah, right. Yeah. And then the land, all these things, almost we have done it. So now we need actually support from different personalities, from well-wishers and knowledgeable people to bring this, our IBU, we call International Buddhist University, to be a good university, internationally acclaimed or international standard university in the northeastern state of Tripura, which is going to be the gateway to Southeast Asian countries, something like that, through Sabrum, where we are sitting actually. This is a thing I would request everyone kindly support us so that we can revive the knowledge system of India, Indian culture, Indian knowledge system, and India again act or play an important role to bring the harmony, peace again in the world when the world is always at the edge of waging war with one another. So we have to bring peace and happiness and harmony through the teachings of the Buddha, Indian, our thought system. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Dhammapiya ji. It was right from the heart. In fact, you would be so happy to know that from the Southeast Asia, from the ASEAN, yeah. Dato Ramesh Kodamalji He is the co-chairman of ASEAN India Business Council. He is watching this program from Kuala Lumpur, from Malaysia. He is also the chairman of the Goldtex Group of Companies. He's a great supporter. He always wants this particular concept, vision, development, harmony, peace, all that has to come up between India and ASEAN the best possible way. So we are working in that particular direction. At the same time, what I would make a humble request that all our monks, our bhantes, our brothers and sisters, world over, wherever you are, kindly become a part of this particular program. And I'm looking forward to, I would be very happy, even if you take a little less time, 4 people, 5 people, 6 people, we can increase the duration. But let's have more and more knowledge, wisdom, everything coming true. Because I have got 4th of July, 11th of July, 18th of July, 25th of July, 1st of August, and 8th of August. And 15th of August, we wish to present our final report to the Honorable Minister HRD, and we wish to send it across to Honorable Prime Minister's office. So that is the way we want to work on this entire system. And we are going ahead. And last 2 days, you'll be so happy to know, not yesterday, but day before yesterday and day before yesterday, we had some of the very important legends, and they basically were on to Nalanda. The deliberations were on Nalanda University. It was a great knowledge on me, and I learned quite a bit of it. You have got a very pious, very sincere dream project. And from world over, whatsoever best our chamber can pour in, we'll keep requesting people to support this vision and this university coming up over there. My only request is that more and more brothers and sisters from the world over should come as a part of next 7 Saturdays are very important for us. And 4th of July, already you have told very pious. I was reading this morning that 6th of July is the 85th birthday of His Holiness Dalai Lama Ji. And there's a music album coming. And that music album, the track, 11 tracks are being done with New Zealand. And that particular tracks and other things which are coming, the entire donation will go towards the education, development, and you know, environment protection, couple of things. So I'm pretty sure for the good cause, for the knowledge, what you made a mention, and competencies, what we may mention, a lot of things will come, and your sincere efforts will get some daylight soon. With these words, one question I want to just take on, somebody has posed it. It has come from Suchitra Sitapathi. How do we build resilience in children? Today's world demand that children become strong and responsible adults who will not believe that the world revolves around them. So how to basically take care of children? That's the summing up of, you know.
Yeah. Okay. Definitely, the mind of different age group.
Yes.
Have different kind of requirement.
Yes.
So definitely, what as the teachers, educators, we have to do is let the students or the children be open and inquire by themselves, give freedom to them. At the same time, we have to inculcate. It is not imposing upon, but inculcate with the good habit system. Good habit system where they will experience themselves. If something positive, good thing is done, it's pleasant, it's good, and everybody likes something pleasant, right? And the bad habit that also we have to teach them, inculcate by experience. If something bad and wrong is being done, it leads to unpleasant experience or painful things like that. So I think we have to teach the children by giving freedom to think freely, and also by experience, develop the good habit formation, and that is think positive, good thinking, and good way of doing things. And also at the same time, we have to teach practically how the compassion to be practiced, how the compassion to be practiced in the real life. And if we do these things, if children can adopt or can be inculcated, brought into this kind of practice, then slowly things may get better. Definitely, there is always the other aspect also, but we can hope for the better. But now, before I conclude, I would also say, I inform you that on 4th July, IBC, International Buddhist Confederation, is going to celebrate Ashadi Purnima in a grand scale, that is in a virtual celebration, in a virtual form, digital celebration, where we'll be having the whole day program. It may start at morning at 8 o'clock from Saranath, where the Buddha has given the first sermon, the first Dhamma talk, or the first sutra, that's the sutta, that is Dhamma Chakra Pavattana Sutta, or Dharma Chakra Pavattana Sutra. So the chanting of the sutra and some pujas will be started on 4th July, around maybe 8 o'clock or so from Saranath. Then from it may take around 1 hour or so. From there, there'll be live program from Rashtrapati Bhavan, from the residence means from the place of Rashtrapati, yeah, the president of India.
Rashtrapati Bhavan.
It may be around 9, yeah, Rashtrapati Bhavan. It may be 9, 9:30, we do not know yet. Maybe around that time. 9, 9:30, I think, from Rashtrapati Bhavan. We are not sure now. Maybe we'll be getting the timing by today or tomorrow. And then there'll be video messages and live talks from different masters from all over the world. And then in the evening, there'll be a cultural program and then some maybe a presentation of on the life of the Buddha or teachings of the Buddha, something like that in the evening. So I would request everyone to join on 4th of July and to join our Saturday, this talk series on empowerment of education, that is making education relevant through Buddha's teaching or by Buddha's teaching, and empower the world to be a better world, to live, to have a better life. That is what my request to all my venerable monks, masters, nuns, and lay people, for everyone, kindly join us. Thank you so much, our ICSI, right? International yes, Chambers yes. of Service Industry, especially yes. our Dr. Gulshan Sharmaji, for including, allotting us some slot into your journey. So we are also traveling with you. We'll not get down, I hope, in any station till we reach the destination of 15th of August. We lost connection.
Yes, I don't know because somewhere it's a technical fault. In fact, on your behalf, Dhamma Piyaji, I will also make a request that all the universities, all the colleges world over, those are teaching Buddhist philosophy, Buddhism related studies and all, we would like to invite those scholars also to be a part of panel discussions and all. And we will not text them to write any paper in advance or something like that. We just want the veterans should come, they should deliberate, they should empower, and they should share their thought process with us. It would be a great, great gesture. And we are looking forward to that in that direction.
Yes, yes, yes. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Wish you all a great day ahead. And thank you very much for coming. We pray to Almighty for all good days ahead for the entire humanity. Thank you, sir. Thanks for joining. Thank you.